Though we might have defeated the walls of high school, there is still much to learn in life. Each and every one of us never stops from learning. The fact that you are here tonight is the proof that you are a fluorescent gemstone with a beautiful aura. An aura so strong that even the gossipers and the negative influences around would want a part of. Many years ago, in a place of negativity and death, I was born. My surroundings weren't much agreeable to what other kids had. I come from a humble family, and I know with all my heart that they are still humble to this day. But I am not only talking about my family and blood. I am also talking about my family of the class of 2012. Many of you here that are present here today remember me as being weird yet amusing. Some may even remember me as being a British Latino. I felt at home, yet escaping a life of turmoil and a life of paranoia was not only my goal, but my mother's goal as well. We suffered from verbal abuse almost every day of our lives. And I know that the majority of us here have also suffered from verbal abuse. Yet we are stronger than those words of indulgent pain. With you being here tonight, it proves to the world that we are a strong and promising future. To be honest with you, these past 4 or 5 years have been the most luminous in all of my life's history. Yet I still had and have those moments in life where it might serve me as a lesson. Throughout my early childhood, before I met the class of 2012, I was timid. While other kids had many friends, I tried to get along with them and never succeeded. Sometimes I felt like an annoyance to society. Nobody wanted to play with the short kid that had wide open gap teeth. My only friend was my mother, in whom I loved and cherished. When nobody wanted to play with me, she would. My mother taught me the colors, the numbers, and the words. I can happily say that she was the reason why I was a year ahead of the kindergartners and only spent a couple of days in that grade. A mother's love is unconditional.
It's 1 year in advance.
She showed me how to love what I do, how to love people unconditionally, and most importantly, how to love myself. We, Spartans, are strong people. We have shown the world tonight that we do not give up. It grieves me when our own classmates drop out in their last year of high school. That shows that we must work in some areas as well. We as Spartans must know how to discipline ourselves in order to achieve great works. We must sacrifice things in our lives in order to obtain a higher standard of living. There will be situations in life where you must tighten your belt in order to not cause an economic, spiritual, and an emotional crisis. Life is not free, even in education. If you want a high score in your essay, you have to work hard in order to achieve the fruit of your labor, which is the high grade. We must plant seeds of optimism and prosperity in our minds and in our lives. If you haven't realized, education is a seed. If you continue to cultivate on that seed, always working and never giving up, sooner or later, that seed will become a tree. And that tree will take care of you and your future family. 4 years of education after high school is nothing, and I repeat, nothing compared to a lifetime of prosperity and wealth. We must understand the law of sowing and reaping.
That's right.
It is short-term pain for long-term pain.
Woo.
If you apply that deeply into yourself, I guarantee to each and every one of you that it will change your life. Special thanks to Mr. Simpkins for always being there for me and for Apostle. God bless the class of 2012, our families, our faculty and staff, our teachers, and most importantly, our nation. Thank you.
Yeah, baby!